अबे मैं तेरे को बोल रहा हूँ, मेरा एनेस्थीसिया वेयर ऑफ हो जाएगा, फिर मेरा पेन शुरू होगा, फिर नहीं कर पाऊंगा।
फिर करना कारफैक्स, कारफैक्स।
अभी भी नाउ इट्स प्रूफ दैट वरुण हैज टू हैव एनेस्थेटिक, लाइक ही हैज टू बी एनेस्थेटाइज्ड बिफोर ही डज दिस पॉडकास्ट।
एनेस्थेटिक जेल। चल रेडी, 3 2 1 गो। हेलो एंड वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ द इंटरनेट सेंस शो, वी टेक रैंडम हिस्ट्री शॉक फैक्ट, शॉक
टॉक फैक्ट्स,
random shit, funny weird shocking facts and
go grow up as connect to feeling nahi hai na, kuch feeling nahi
hai, wow
dev after dentist
oh shit
wapas, that was the dumbest thing varun has ever done, varun ne mere se aise
I don't remember do.
That's either anesthesia or Indian upbringing. It's one of those two things.
No, no. दांत काम नहीं कर रहा, मारो.
My problem is that now when Varun, when the anesthesia wears off, it's going to be the pain of the surgery and the slap that he has hit on that part.
क्या जिफ बनेगा रेडिट पे? Oh fuck, मजेदार.
चल, वापस करूँ opening. Hold up. Hello and welcome to another episode of the Internet Said So Show. We take random interesting
shocking, weird, absurd.
Random interesting, shocking, weird facts, stats, trivia, and our personal stories, and we talk about it. And my first personal story is that my board is dumb, so I'm bahut struggle kar raha hu ye bolne mein.
Struggle. I think all S words are a problem.
Struggle. Sean Connery.
Shocking.
This is how I'm going to talk for the rest of the episode.
Money.
Okay, so the topic for today's episode is cars. कार यानी गाड़ी यानी गड्डी
गाड़ी
तो सबसे पहले तुमने उसने ड्राइविंग कभी चालू की लाइफ में? फर्स्ट टाइम गाड़ी कब चला?
16
16
तू भी 16?
हाँ
कौतुक?
नो आई वाज 19
I was actually 4 years old in my dad's lap because everybody's first drive was बाप के गोद में बिठा के बाप कंट्रोल कर रहे हैं सब तेरे को स्टेरिंग दे दिए और तू
physics and mechanics.
No, because like in all of our times, like Kautuk has never offered to drive. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he has never, we've gone places and Kautuk has never said, हाँ ठीक है ना मैं चला लेगा, like it's not even a concept to ask Kautuk to drive.
क्योंकि Kautuk वो time पे बेवड़ा होके पीछे सो रहा है.
Always.
थोड़ी offer करेगा वो time.
Most of the time.
Bro, on the way back from Shilim.
Wait, wait, oh my god.
Kautuk is only moving with the car movement.
No, and but I'm scared ke baba. Haan, bola.
Fuck, dude, that ride from Shilim. So basically what happened was we had all gone for an offside to Shilim. Okay. And Bawa had a meeting the next day. Okay. Correct. At 10 in the morning. Okay, and I was also like, chal, this is great, I'll get a ride back.
I was supposed to go in the night. Adar and Kautuk said, yeah. Subha jana bro, hum log bhi aayega tere
saath. 100% aayega, right?
He and said it's dangerous to go down the ghats at night because it was a lot of fog, okay?
But 6 a.m. is fine, but okay, haan, chalo. Yeah.
It's daylight.
Uh-huh. And I wanted Bawa to go in the morning because A, I'll get a ride and B, I can drink and pass out on the car.
Yeah.
So,
the reason I think we could have gone with Varun, but the problem was Varun guarantee शाम को जा रहा था और मेरा और कौतुक का शो था शायद. That's why
मैं सुबह निकला है दोपहर.
वो Varun को chill मार के 12 o'clock
बस सुबह उठ के breakfast पूरा दबा के.
हाँ.
Correct.
So we left with Bawa at 6 in the morning. Okay, I have slept.
That Bawa has slept. Kautuk has just come into the room and saying, chalo, I'm ready to go. And he's taken his bag without anything. He's just lifted up his bag and walked. Yeah,
yeah. I put down my last drink and I was like, chal, Bawa, let's go.
Isliye na, phir Bawa chalega, tu bed, chill.
No, but Bawa, okay, at 6 in the morning, it's like that fog has set in, okay, on the hills. And Bawa has done that classic thing, right? When it's the fog, you just sit 2 inches ahead.
Yeah.
Because that is what will make you see in the fog.
Because I'm sitting in the front seat. I'm watching Bawa.
No, like, Kautuk is in the front seat.
I am in the front seat, dude.
Arre, Baba, Kautuk and me are both saying he was in the front seat. How are you saying you were in the front seat?
100% you are in the back seat.
Arre, you were in the back seat sleeping out there.
2 inches ahead, he's driving, okay? And the motherfucker, because he has to make it for a 10 a.m. meeting, he's driving down the ghats like it's the F1 race.
Yeah.
Okay, and...
It's not true, dude. A 40 also felt like...
100% true.
Kautuk, you have to understand, you were inebriated.
To Surpa, Baba, I was inebriated when I sat in the car. When he started driving, I was sober. Because mera aisa light on ho
gaya.
I was like, holy shit, Baba. Right? And I was like, 100% he's going to crash the car somewhere. Okay, and what he does is, he somehow manages at some 60 kilometers, he's gone through the whole ghat. He comes to Mumbai and in traffic, when the signal is red, that's when Baba's car gets hit by another car. Aur uska bumper nikal jata.
Oh, shit.
And we spend 10 minutes on the side of the road, okay? He's making calls to the meeting saying, I'm going to be 10 minutes. Bumper pakad ke ghar hai.
Now it sounds like Baba's making a fake excuse.
Yeah.
Mera traffic mein accident ho gaya. But the thing about cars, right? Even if it's not your own car, that the feel of a car getting grazed or hit or bumped against, you can feel it, and it's probably one of the worst feelings ever.
Agreed, Varun. It's really the worst feeling when you see it happen. But when you're sitting at home and you hear one guy go, in your head, if there is no thud at the end of the. You feel incomplete. You're like, where's the thud? Like, you want to hear the thud, bro. Shit.
It's like you've scratched yourself. This is some like good drivers versus bad drivers. And so what happens is good drivers think of the car as an extension of themselves. So they actually think that this is an extra appendage. Like, they actually think that it is part of them.
Yes,
Bad drivers can't do that. Bad drivers think that the car is conspiring against them.
I used to think my car was an extension of my dad's body. Because that's how he used to also tell me, he don't fuck it up. Which is why I never learned how to drive properly.
What was the car you learned on?
देश की गाड़ी मारुति 800 पहले बार जो चलाया because even our first car like the first family car we had was मारुति 800
yeah
so true. I didn't obviously get to drive that immediately but
because you were
पहला
ऐसे
थोड़ा बहुत हाँ
because you were 5 right at the time I'm assuming
no we got the car when I was about 10-12 years old I guess first car which was the
but 800. One sec did you have the मारुति 800 with the Jap engine and the AC button on the side that didn't, like you had to roll down, which worked on the accelerator.
It had power steering and power windows, by which I mean you had to put power to put it down, and you had to put power.
Even my first car was no
like
power steering.
Like ship ko turn kar raha hai, wo wala. Ki pura aise, by the end of your drive, tere bicep aa gaye, bro. Kyunki tu itna usko aise pull kiya. But
my dad had a standard 2000. So he had a standard 2000.
That is four Marutis put together.
Yeah.
No. So it's a really cool car. I remember it was a red color standard 2000. And in those days, he had a wiper at the back. It was quite a legend. Yeah, like,
with somebody from the inside had to move, na?
It was imported type car. So, but we sold that pretty early on in life. Then I didn't have a car all the way till I was 20. Till I was 19 or something. And Mom bought me a second-hand Maruti 800 after me throwing a tantrum saying I want it. Or literally 3 months chala hai wo gaadi aur wo hum logo dono ko chutiya bana ke wo aadmi ne paisa leke
kitna paisa
80,000 rupees.
Oh, wow, that's like 3 lakhs right now.
Yeah,
maybe more. That was a second-hand Maruti 800. I just threw a tantrum that no, I don't need a car. Mom bought it. Then she said, fuck you, I told you so. Phir mere paise se hi kata
hua. But it's crazy to see ki wo time pe jab tu gaadi liya, right? Jab ye gaadi aaya hoga, phir tu bahar jaake Pioneer ka wo removable deck khareeda hoga. Kyunki wo removable nahi kya to chori ho jayega.
Dude, the Maruti 800, the accelerator was connected if you had the one with the aircon. If you had the one with the aircon, it's like a headlight of a scooty. It's connected to the accelerator. So if you were stuck in traffic, the AC's compressor wasn't working. You had to press the accelerator for the compressor to come on.
Yeah.
Because it was working on the engine. It's crazy, dude, in those days.
But imagine, bro, what removable system say abhi aajkal. Like, I like how India has now obviously reached a point where even the smallest of cars have a lot of the features that you would consider premium as part of the basic feature. Like in the US, pretty much every car that gets made has a rear cam.
Yeah.
Not, apne idhar hota tha rear horn, right? Which used to be more often than not.
No. It was,
bro.
It was always सोच ना क्या जो भी होगा देखा जाएगा which is wrong क्योंकि जब तुम reverse कर रहे हो that is the last song you want to hear
that's the song sorry my bad that's the song that's correct but ये मैंने ये भी देखा है हद से गुजर जिंदगी whatever
dude that's all of this
song it copied from
yeah
उसका tune as the rare one right
dude it is
Beethoven
But no, now from there it's gone to pretty much all the new cars. Even the base variant will have a rear cam. In US, it became mandatory. You know, because
in the US, all sorts of cams are mandatory, including police cams. So
but you remember, like I remember there were two competitive. You're talking about those speaker systems. There were those two competitive ones, right? Like, there was Blaupunkt and there was Kenwood. Those were the thing. Or फिर एक like ऐसा एक मेरा cousin है. He's basically has installed. He has utilized his entire Maruti Swift's dicky with woofers. He can't
Very
put
common.
A bag in it anymore. He's
Very
that
common.
Bad that. I don't understand why people end up doing all
but
of this.
But ये public तो करता था because उसका phase ही ऐसा था जब तेरा Blaupunkt, Pioneer ये सब आने लग गया फिर तू कितने वो छोटी से गाड़ी में तू कितना स्पीकर डाल सकता है ये एक बड़ी मजा और सीन हो गया था तो वो गाड़ी पेट्रोल वेट्रोल से आगे नहीं जा रही वो साउंड से वाइब्रेट होते हुए जा रही है ब्रो आई हैव सीन देन दैट आई एनीवे हैव वेरी लिटिल ग्राउंड क्लियरेंस गेट दबा आउट बिकॉज भारी ऊपर कुछ डाला है पब्लिक में और घुमा रहे कितने लोखंड वाला में
लोकंड वाला बैंड स्टैंड
बैक रोड ये सब पे जो
मेरी
लेट्स गो टू सम फैक्ट्स ठीक है तो फर्स्ट स्टीम पावर्ड ऑटोमोबाइल कैपेबल ऑफ ह्यूमन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कब था बता
यस अबाउट 1895
वैदिक एज
नो
वैदिक एज
ड्यूरिंग द फ्लिंटस्टोन लेकिन उसमें उसको उठा के भागना पड़ता था गाड़ी में
लाइक वो यू टर्न मारते टाइम ऐसे उठा के गाड़ी को रखता था लाइक द ईज
टू पैरेलल पार्किंग सोच फ्लिंटस्टोन के लिए इजी इंजन नहीं किधर भी घुसा सकता है सो इट वाज इन 1769 बाय द वे एंड इट वाज बिल्ट बाय अ गाय कॉल्ड निकोलस जोसेफ कुग्नो मतलब कुगनॉट है बट आई एम अज्यूमिंग इट्स अ फ्रेंच नेम सो आई एम pronouncing it like a French person.
Self-propelled vehicle, no?
First steam-powered automobile capable of human transportation.
Yeah. But I think we started looking at actually on-road was like 1895, 1902, that kind of...
Yeah, 1885, Carl Benz. He was the guy who made the first petrol-powered or gasoline-powered automobile.
Right.
So, and it was Carl's Benz. I think Mercedes-Benz wala dono ka usse hi aaya hoga shayad. Okay. And then 1908 mein, the Model T, which was by
Tesla.
Ford.
Henry Ford.
Yeah.
Henry Ford. 1908.
As good,
Model T became so popular. It became pretty much like America's car and all of that. But until 1924, 20% of, half the cars in the world were Ford.
Also, I just want to say there was a great ad that had come where they said it comes in all colors. It comes in all colors only if it's black or something like that. Like it was, you can get it in any color you want as long as it's black.
It sounds like a BMW ad.
You know why they called the Model T?
Why?
Called the Model T because they had this succeeded the Model S.
Yeah.
It basically means he started with the Model A and by the time it worked, it was Model T.
Yeah.
But he was known to do that kind of stuff, right? Actually go like absolutely like revolutionized how
wo bhi wo dekh wo dekha ki nahi Ford versus Ferrari dekha ki nahi movie
that
also the history is quite intense
I also want to state a great fact which is almost 95% of a car's lifespan is spent parked but if you are in India 99% of it is spent parked because you are also in traffic for the other 4%
Apparently, in Britain, this is a British statistic. Most Britons who own cars spent 99 days in traffic in their lifespan.
Yeah, and US ka bhi aisa kuch tha. 38 hours a year stuck in traffic.
Kaushik, you want to do your joke or what?
What joke?
Your joke of how long do you spend in traffic from life?
So I was just going to say 99 days is one way to Andheri.
Yeah,
okay, it's one. Why would you?
Dude, it's so scary in London, by the way. In London, the fees as you come into the zones, like from the widest zone to the inner zone, like zone one, the toll fee to drive in zone one, forget park in zone one, to drive in zone one is so exorbitant. It is unaffordable, even in New York.
System, no, explain zone system. Kya hai?
Oh, zone. London's basically like
grids,
Paris.
Grids.
Like
yeah.
Paris also.
Like Bangalore. Like Ring Road.
No. The thing is, it's divided into zones from outward to inward. So you can imagine it as circles or squares or whatever, but they're concentric. Inward. So as you come into the central part of London to enter, also there is a fee to drive in it. There is a fee, and the parking is just bhool jao. Matlab you park in another place and take the tube and come, because it's insane to park in London. Same with New York. Parking in New York is so ridiculously expensive.
Bro, it's a business getting parking lots and running.
There's entire buildings dedicated to just parking. Yeah.
It's my friend in New York has a bike, which he does. And he parks it, because it's New York, he can only ride it for 6-8 months of the year, right? For the time that he's not going to ride it for sure, he puts it in storage. He's like, I can't afford to keep it parked anywhere. So I will put it in storage. That's how expensive it is.
So in Palladium, the mall, when we could go to Palladium, the mall, my parents and I, we got the worst parking attendant of all time. Okay, parking was full, but like, so, you know, he confidently comes out, okay, saying, I'll parking dikhata ho. Okay, he starts walking, he starts bringing us, okay. He literally walked the entire parking lot and then he said, parking full hai.
But it displays up on top.
Yeah. That's the fucking point, no? He was a fucking
three
dumbass.
Left, two left.
He brought us all the way, come, and then he said, abhi upar jao.
And the
but there are some people who fight. I love how some people fight. It's like, "Wapas, there's zero parking. Kaise? Arey, hoga na kuch na kuch. Dekho. Sir, yahan pe likha hai zero. Main yahan pe khada hu kaafi der se. Main bol raha hu genuinely. Upar milega. Nahi, mere ko yahan pe karne ka.
Arey, it's damn bad. Dude, have you driven abroad left hand side?
Bro, autobahn.
Yeah.
Fuck anything else in the world. But my first this was, bro. This is my favorite story to tell because. I probably already said it, but fuck it, I'll say it again. Driving abroad wala scene, and that's, we had gone to Croatia. So we landed in Zagreb, which is the capital. Or vahan se, we had to go to a port town called Split, which is 456 kilometers away, right? To catch a ferry to take us to Var, which is the island we wanted to go to. Or agar ye wala boat miss kiya,
was Var very far?
It's very Var.
Okay.
Good.
Did you go with Parivar?
Nahi yaar.
Baba, next time, Baba, give some warning before you do this shit. Yeah.
Good. Yeah, yeah. See, we will get VAR in football also. Nah, sorry. Chal bol.
Yuck.
You hear hey, going there. It was just a matter of when.
I was very predictable. Come on, let's go. Sorry.
Okay, now can Varun speak?
Very nice. Very nice.
Boom. Anyway, so हम लोग उधर जाके गाड़ी रेंट किया है ठीक है और रेंट करके लेफ्ट हैंड ड्राइव निकला है तो गरीब तभी जितना भी सब पैसा बचा था वी टुक अ स्कोडा फाबिया दे हैव दिस वन ट्राइंग टू इमिटेट द ऑटोबान दे आल्सो हैव वन इट्स कॉल्ड E71 और E73 वन ऑफ द टू ठीक है उस पे क्रोएशिया
क्रोएशिया
सो दैट द टूरिज्म हैज बूम्ड राइट तो उन लोग ने capital city se split, which is the journey that most people take, they made a fucking highway. So udhar tu bhaga gaadi. Dude, I'm not kidding. Because there is, ek to tu bhaga sakta hai, plus unno ke highway pe khadde nahi jaise apne idhar hai. बीच में देखो ऐसे हाईवे पे फ्री पूरा हाईवे उस पे खड्डे है थोड़े या ग्रेवल है यार उधर स्मूथ 140 के स्पीड पे था मैं वो एंड आई डिडंट फील लाइक आई वाज लाइक अ माइल ओवर 60 ऐसे तू चला रहा है चिल तू क्रूज कंट्रोल डाल भगा गाड़ी एंड इट इज द मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल सीनिक लाइक इवन अपना सीलिंग क्या बोल रहा है अपना एक्सप्रेस भी मस्त है लेकिन खड़बड़ी उधर जाके एक सडनली हिल
यू नो यू नेवर हैव दैट नेवर आई विल गिव यू द बेस्ट एग्जांपल ओके सो व्हेन आई वाज ड्राइविंग इन द बिकॉज़ आई स्टेड इन द यूएस एंड आई वाज ड्राइविंग देयर आई यूज्ड टू हैव दिस टेरिबल हैबिट ओके सो व्हेनेवर आई वाज ड्राइविंग एंड आई अप्रोच्ड अ सिग्नल एंड द सिग्नल वाज ग्रीन राइट आई वुड स्लो डाउन ओके सो ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स वुड ऑलवेज लुक एट मी एंड बी लाइक What the who slows down if or mere ko ek do horn bhi pad raha hai, which is a gali basically.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Because it's green. Why the fuck are you slowing down? I'm like, bro, kidhar aur se koi bhi car
le raha hai. Sakta hai.
So you're like, they're like, bro, just you, if you see green or even if it's amber, just zip through, dude. It blindly you can zip through. Okay, so it's crazy, dude. I remember driving through a mall. And there was a stop sign.
Driving through a mall.
like mall ka parking lot se nikal ke car
mein. Very likely Baba can drive through a mall.
Yeah, yeah. Cable, cable. Gaya, sidha Zara se bahar nikal raha hai.
So, Baba ready ho gaya.
Every time I want to go.
Rota tha aisa hota na ki aise ye ironic t-shirt pehen ke andar ke aur tha crash karke Zara se nikla aur pura look.
Pura suit woot ha.
So I remember we were driving, came out and my friends were drunk. So they're like, you're sure you'll drive? I was like, yeah, and all left hand. So by now I'd gotten slightly used to it. But automatic. So automatic and left hand is way better than manual and left hand drive. So,
oh, won't you sakta because tera heart, you're used to this used muscle to this memory. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
but wo 15 minute lagta hai, bro. 15 minutes.
Yeah, yeah. It's not difficult to adjust, but but I'm saying an automatic is definitely easier. So these guys were drunk. So I was driving. I was DD. As I was driving through the mall, we came to a stop sign. It was 1:45 in the night or something like that. Okay. And there was a stop sign inside the campus of a mall. You've still not gone out of the main gate. And koi nahi tha, pone 2 baje raat ko, toh main nikal gaya. They all in their inebriated state have gone, wait, stop. I'm like, what happened? They're like, bro, you ran a stop sign. I'm like, there isn't a soul for miles. They said, it doesn't matter. You see a stop hexagon, you stop. Yeah. Like, it is a dead stop and then go.
Yeah.
Abhi main jaake wo sab right of way aur wo sab seekha hai, bro. Right of way, kya rule hai? If you are at a four junction or a circle, it's simple. Whoever comes to the junction first, it's their turn to go. Yeah. Kya? Aur kuch traffic nahi hota because of, traffic hai, but it's not because of...
This is not the rule in India at all.
Yeah.
This is whoever is at the junction has the right of way.
Yeah. Whoever decides to have the balls to go first is first.
Bro, iske liye to mera America mein first joke bhi ye tha. Here in your country, you have right of way. In India, we have get out of the way. Ye joke likha hai maine stage pe kiya ye.
Are, kya baat hai? Right.
Oh. Fir uske, I followed that up with you guys have four seasons. We have two seasons, summer and not summer. ये भी joke मैं stage पे.
ये मैंने ये मुझे याद है ये मुझे बाबा का joke है. This was the opening joke that he used to do in Bombay also.
No, like, not in Bombay.
Hey, I've seen you do this joke in Bombay. Flip करके तो Bombay में करता था.
अरे चल आगे बढ़ते हैं अलग थोड़े facts ढूँढो.
Okay,
okay, horsepower. I've got this weird one about horsepower. It's not really a horse's power. Like, it's wrong. So, one horsepower technically is supposed to be...
Oh, shit. Thanks, Adar. I thought they were calculating ghode ka speed and attributing it to...
No, but they've actually calculated it here. That's the weird part. So, one horsepower in like metric...
In horse terms.
In scientific terms would be... 746 watts, which is about 33,000 lb-ft of torque per minute. Which
oh, good. That
pound lb-ft is pounds per feet of torque.
Point, but there's no slash. Whatever. Acha, pounds per feet.
Pound
of,
foot of torque. Yeah. Pound foot of torque. Huh. Sorry, minute. Torque is multiplied, not divided. Yeah. Sorry. Okay.
So and. they've calculated that an actual horse would actually generate only 0.7% of one horsepower. Average horse would do that.
तो गाड़ी का पावर ज्यादा है घोड़े से ये बोलना चाहता है
गाड़ी का एक हॉर्स पावर का पावर ज्यादा है एक घोड़े से लाइक बट
घोड़े का कार पावर कितना है
घोड़े का कार पावर
मूविंग ऑन टू अनदर कार फैक्ट
आई वुड रादर हैव अ
आई वांट टू नो व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज योर व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज द अकॉर्डिंग टू द वर्ल्ड दिस इज अ वर्ल्ड स्टैटिस्टिक फ्रॉम 2013 देयर वाज एन ऑस्ट्रेलियन स्टडी दैट डिड इट व्हिच डू यू थिंक इज द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट फेवरेट कलर्ड कार
It's either black,
black.
Or it's black. Red.
Black.
Or white.
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 White is the world's most popular colored car. In fact, they say that 10% of white cars are likely to be involved, are less likely to be involved in 10% 90% less
accident. Of white cars will be shat upon by birds.
Yes.
No, that 90% of any car or anything that even remotely resembles a car. You just have a car cover hanging outside.
It's so much more on a white car, dude. And it's like so much more noticeable also.
Hey, kale pe zyada hota hai.
Nahin, bro, kya bol raha hai? Mere gaadi kaali hai. Uspe agar aake एक दस हल्का भी किया तो इतना बड़ा लगता है
डूड एक घंटे के लिए काली गाड़ी तू छोड़ेगा ना कहीं बॉम्बे में इट लुक्स लाइक देयर इज एन एंटायर फिल्म ऑफ डस्ट ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट जस्ट मैजिकली
नो देयर इज अ फिल्म ऑफ डस्ट एंड देन देयर आर आर्टिस्ट्स हु विल कम एंड दे विल राइट देयर नेम इन इट
या
बाय द वे टॉकिंग अबाउट डर्टी कार्स रशिया में इट्स अ क्रिमिनल ऑफेंस टू ड्राइव अ डर्टी कार
आई
डोंट क्यू आई मीन क्यों उधर ऐसा क्या है
Yeah.
No. There are several rules. Like for example, I have been pulled over because my left tail light was not working.
That's
just
legit.
My left brake light.
That's Aray, legit.
That is legit because that affects the other driver who's behind you or somebody so else to see because you are able to communicate with them and they understand that communication. Not like here कि देखो left दिखाने के बाद भी left हाथ भी बाहर लेना पड़ता है और फिर किसी को पीछे बोलना पड़ता है चिल्ला के बोल उसको मैं left ले रहा हूँ
नहीं नहीं हम लोग ऐसे नहीं हम लोग ऐसा this is our
this is
the best one is
चल ठीक है तूने अगर sorry बोला ना मैं माफ कर दूँ ये ऐसा करते हैं फिर तुझे लुक देते हैं कि अरे मैं ये कर रहा था तुझे मालूम नहीं है देखो मालूम नहीं है कि मैं रोज ऐसे हाईवे के बीच में से रैंडमली लेफ्ट लेता हूँ 90 डिग्री एंगल पे या
आई वाज कमिंग बैक टुडे आई वाज ऑन द एक्सप्रेसवे सम गाय has decided to take a U-turn वो जो एक होता है for the rescue वो जो उन लोगों की पुलिस की गाड़ी चलती है so there's a break in the Mumbai Pune expressway where only those people are allowed to take the U-turn this guy has stopped and that U-turn has to be in the right lane तो ये right lane में रुक के ऐसे खड़ा है और रुका है so half his ass is out on the expressway and he's got his sign out
this is why Varun I don't drive fast on the expressway because suddenly there'll be one biker which is not allowed coming in your direction
ऑटोबान
यू कांट ड्राइव स्लो
तू ऐसे आके ऐसे डॉक्टर कोपनीस के जमाने की गाड़ी लेके चल मैं देखता हूँ कैसा है इसका सीनरी 60 पे चलाऊंगा नहीं देखिए तो पहले
आई फुली एग्री विद बाबा डूड लाइक इफ यू आर यूज्ड टू इंडियन ड्राइविंग इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट लाइक माय फादर स्टिल हैज ऐसा रेसिड्यूअल मसल मेमोरी ऑफ अरे धीरे धीरे
नहीं बट कैन आई टेल यू ऑनेस्टली आई डोंट थिंक सो तू बिकॉज तू इधर चला सकता है गाड़ी तू दुनिया में किधर भी चला सकता है
बट यू आर एक्सट्रीमली कॉशियस द पॉइंट इज दैट द कॉन्फिडेंस विद व्हिच यू आर सपोज्ड टू ड्राइव
यू वुड बी बट देन व्हेन यू सी हे ड्राइव मिनिमम एट 100 तू भगाएगा फिर
नो नो दैट्स नॉट व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट स्पीडिंग थ्रू अ रेड लाइट स्पीडिंग थ्रू अ लाइट व्हेन इट्स ग्रीन Like it's just not possible. I'm telling you the amount of times I have slowed down.
The trust on people is not there. You don't trust human beings to observe those lights.
Because first of all, there are people standing in the line. New York, horrible city to drive. Because that right turn in New York, though, it's chaos.
Bhai, kuch hai nahi, jagah hi nahi hai. Toh kaise chala hai? Aadhe log toh, bro, when you, which is why when you get to walk, why the fuck would you drive? Because I sat in a cab once and there was the worst decision I made. I said, मेरे को चल के जाने में 10 मिनट 15 20 मिनट चल और लगता मेरे $50 बच जाते and I would have had more fun. Here, you can't, तू क्या बॉम्बे में चल के जा रहे किधर?
No chance. You've driven a, of course, I know the Ferrari you drove also.
I have been next to...
And you did a, you kharochod the bumper, no? The thing at the bottom?
Yeah, I hit the chassis on bandstand. I hit the chassis on a speed breaker. The guy with me, like, he was just so chill about it. Like, he told me to stop before the speed breaker. I stopped, but I didn't completely stop. It was literally his... The thing is, if you want to drive a Ferrari in Bombay, you have to stop like a stop sign. Like, complete stop. और फिर फरारी उसके ऊपर से धीरे से ग्लाइड होके जाएगी।
And that too you have to, I think, take it at an angle. You can't take it straight up.
You go like this and then this. That's the idea. And if you go a little over, like 0.5 kilometer over, it'll scratch. And it's like, yeah, ये तो होता ही है. ये तो I have made.
Can I tell you? So Adar had a BMW. Okay.
That is hilarious. Adar's BMW is hilarious.
I got a bit out of Adar's by just sitting in Adar's BMW. So we are sitting in his car and the speed breaker comes, okay? And the clearance is so low and the speed breaker is so high, right? There is a sherpa on the speed breaker. So it's going over the speed breaker, kharaj jata pura. And I was sitting there and I could hear the money being scraped off.
Yeah.
So that's the like, worst. When the underneath of your car hits on a bad speed bump, it's the worst feeling.
क्या
क्या फिर कोई चूतिया रस्ते पे सिगरेट फूंक
के फाइनल डेस्टिनेशन की तरह स्लो मोशन में
डू योर इम्पर्सनेशन ऑफ अ रिक्शा वाला राइडिंग अ स्पीड बम्प नो
It's just not in a rickshaw. At any point in your life, whenever you've been in a rickshaw, it's just like you rickshaw walas don't stop for speed breakers. And like you're sitting there and all of us have had the feeling of like aram se baithe and then this shit that happens in a rickshaw. And the rickshaw wala has gotten used to it. So he doesn't even react. So he's just
he's
expressionless. He doesn't care of what is happening.
That's so true. That's accurate.
He knows it's coming, right? Tell me, fastest car you've been in the presence of or driven?
Abhe, sorry, tumne Ferrari ki baat kare, isliye main bolunga. Theek hai, India mein, at least Bombay mein, Ferrari kiske paas thi?
Tere paas.
Sachin.
Nahi, Sachin. Pehli Ferrari. First Ferrari. First Ferrari was Sachin.
I don't know if it was the first one.
Agar mere paas Ferrari ek din ke liye bhi hoti na, you wouldn't have stopped listening. ड्राइव पे निकलते ना तो इन लोग ड्राइव पे निकले सैंट्रो इन लोग के पास ठीक है और इन लोग सैंट्रो को भगा रहे रेक्लेमेशन पे बिकॉज तू पूरे बॉम्बे में देखो तेरी गाड़ी यूज करनी है ना अच्छे से तो रेक्लेमेशन जाना पड़ता है उधर वो भी रात वात को या अर्ली मॉर्निंग जब भी खाली है तो तू कर सकता है तो
मेरे घर के पास
और सडनली उन लोगों को ना आवाज आ रही है लिटरली तेको अगर फरारी आएगी ना तो तेको दूर से सुनाई देगा कि आ रही है तो उसका लाइक वूं वूं ऐसा कुछ तो ये हुआ है मैंने क्या है फक फरारी कुछ स्पोर्ट्स कार है कुछ तो है और गाड़ी बाजू में आके रुकी है तो दीज गाइस हैव स्लोड डाउन की अरे फरारी है विंडो नीचे गए इन लोग ने और उधर भी विंडो नीचे हुई है और है उसमें सचिन और सचिन उन लोग बोले कि स्लो चलाओ
Bro, Sachin ka kya problem hai life mein yaar?
Wear helmet at back also. Problem hai.
Wear helmet at the back, drive slow in the front. Like, what is happening to Sachin?
Nahi, lekin wo logo bol raha slow chalao. फिर सब लोग कहते हैं कि अरे
फरारी
छुपी है और फिर सचिन बाय विंडो पर और भागे तो खुद फरारी में इवन योर मिनिमम स्पीड इज
या या
टॉप स्पीड फॉर दिस फकिंग सेंट्रो तो ऐसे एक्सेलरेटर पे ये करेगा तो वुप चले जाएगा
या या या
But it'd be hilarious, right? If like Sachin is such a nice guy on the road, ki agar
no, he wasn't angry. He wasn't exactly. out of like saying it sweetly.
Right, like agar tera speed breaker pe gaya bhi gaadi, right? Aur tera fuel se leak ho raha hai. Sachin aake personally bolega, "Aapka fuel tank actually dekho tera."
Dude, for people who have supercars, there are schools. There's a school in America, and I think California or something. They train. People to drive supercars. Like just because the logic is just because you can buy a car, supercar doesn't mean you can drive it. You have to learn how to drive it. So they actually have sessions where like a child comes in, what is the maneuver you do if a child runs onto the street? So what can you do to avoid that? So all that training is given to these guys on how to skid the car and how to bring it to a complete stop and shit like that. Because that's what the cars are capable of.
Who's taking the classes? Rikshawalas.
Rikshawalas.
Bro, but you know the fastest street legal car is the Bugatti Veyron.
Veyron. No, now it's the Bugatti
legal?
Veyron.
What does street legal mean? Like you can't use like
other cars. You can drive it.
Not a racing car.
No, matlab dekho uske you don't need a racing track to drive that car. You tu chala sakta hai. But no, no, so there is top speed there is a 267 new one. Miles per hour.
There is a new one called the Bugatti Chiron, which is Chiron.
That sounds like it's made on Chirwani.
No, it sounds like it's the bodyguard of Salman Khan. Bugatti Chiron.
The Bugatti Chiron does.
That's S level. That's S level security for Salman.
Dude, the Bugatti Chiron does 400 kilometers an hour, or I think it does. Thing, but there's a special key.
The Bugatti Veyron, which is street legal, its top speed is 431 kilometers per hour.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So the Chiron
what
is more.
Speed is it legal or what?
No, no, no. So I'll explain to you. The Bugatti Veyron or the Chiron has a special key. So if you want to, first of all, that 431 kilometers an hour. The amount of petrol you burn, you won't last more than like 8 kilometers or something like that. So it's So this is all Top Gear when Top Gear was a thing, right? So there is a special key that you have to get. You literally have to stop the car. Get
I
out
like
of
how
the
it's
car.
A key.
It is a key. You have to do this. So you have to get out of the car near the seat. You have to put the key and turn it. Then it unlocks the thing. Otherwise, road legal. Is a limited speed which works within the thing, but it's still a Bugatti Veyron. So it's
Do you know what the first
key thing sounds like? You know, like, are you sure? Like, you have to do a thing before you can use this. Are you sure you have the fucking space?
Be a psych traffic? There should be a psych eval before you're allowed to go to the other version, which is street legal at 431.
You can't, like, I think this is a safety measure where like अगर तुम सिग्नल पे और कोई like ऐसे सैंड्रो में तुम्हारे बगल में आ गया और वो ज़्यादा तुम लोगों को दिखा रहा है the race race दे रहा है तो you don't just suddenly try to go to 400 kilometers an hour it's just like आपको बाहर निकल के
अरे but to go to 400 you also need road you need सब अगर तेरे सामने सिर्फ गाड़ियाँ हैं बॉम्बे में तो कोई नहीं लेकिन दुबई में Even the cops, bro, they have Lambos and all, right?
Yeah.
और दुबई एक एक ऐसी जगह है जिधर हर एक इंडियन ने at some point of time, मैंने खुद ने 10 बार किया, उधर जाएगा तो कोई होटल के बाहर है तो कोई मॉल के बाहर है उधर रैंडमली एक आके कुछ आके खड़ी होगी गाड़ी और सब लोग उसके सामने जाके एक ये एक
पॉइंट
करेंगे कि ये देखो मेरी औकात की बाहर वाली गाड़ी यू नो
there was a car, the same like a nice, sleek looking sports car. And because it's in India, उसपे भी वो गणपति का on the dashboard है.
Always.
Like
वो तो ये Bhushan Kumar की गाड़ी होगी, bro. Bhushan Kumar की गाड़ी होगी.
Yeah. I'm going to be sharing the
Gallardo.
The Lamborghini Gallardo, superb it is. Okay, so here I'm going to be sharing something. I'm going to be sharing something. Please. Okay, this is the Bugatti Chiron on CarDekho.com.
Oh, I would have called it Chiron.
Okay. Now the first thing they have said is mileage. Oh.
Nobody noticing the EMI that EMI you can actually.
Is, EMI is 41,91,000 per
month.
I अबे ये ईएमआई भरने के लिए ईएमआई लेना पड़ेगा.
इट्स
आई वुड लव इट इफ दे आर डूइंग लाइक नो कॉस्ट ईएमआई लाइक
आई जस्ट वांट टू से
और एचडीएफसी कार्ड पे ले तो कैशबैक.
सी दिस the Bugatti Chiron's speed is limited to 420 kilometers per hour. But the Bugatti will actually build only 500. So if you want to buy it, you have 41 lakhs ka EMI dena padega.
You know something, in this car, you would get from like Lower Parel to Thane in 15 minutes.
No, you would still take 99 days.
No, you would get there, you would get there in 15 minutes.
Nahi ja sakti na.
Aur phir tera 1 hour jata toll naka pe. इक्वल हो जाता
है. नहीं लेकिन अगर तू ये ले रहा है तो तेरे पास ई पास है ना, फिर वो वाला पास है, ड्राइव थ्रू वाला पास.
तेरे पास नहीं है क्योंकि तेरे पास पैसे नहीं है.
तो अगर ये बुगाटी लेके भी खड़े रह के फिर ढूंढ रहा है किल्लर कि अरे 55 रुपया देने का
आ गया यार, सीट के नीचे हाथ डाल रहा है
और फिर बोलना जी कि नहीं है सर सॉरी नहीं है.
नो बट द फनीएस्ट इज यू नो दैट बॉम्बे पुणे एक्सप्रेसवे दे स्टार्टेड दैट रूल दैट इफ यू टुक द टोल कूपन फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट टोल यू नीडेड टू ओनली रीच द सेकंड टोल बाय अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम अदर्स दे वुड फाइन यू बिकॉज़ इट मीन्स दैट यू ओवरस्पेंड. विद दिस टोल विद दिस Chiron यू वुड टेक द थिंग एंड यू वुड बी देयर इन 15 मिनट्स बिकॉज़ इट्स एक्चुअली ओनली 102 किलोमीटर्स सो यू वुड बी देयर इन 15 मिनट्स.
But that you're going through everything.
Yeah.
But तू thumbs up mountain पे left कैसे ले रहा है भाई?
Thumbs up mountain.
Thusnup.
Oh God. अच्छा तो you know what the first speeding ticket actually was? In 1902.
A speeding ticket.
For how much? The first speeding ticket was issued for driving at
speed of 5 kilometers.
45 miles per hour.
Wow.
अभी क्योंकि तभी इमेजिन करना तभी रास्ते पे एक्चुअली लोग चल रहे हैं बिकॉज़ दे वर अलाउड टू जस्ट वॉक राइट और उसके बीच में तू गाड़ी भगा के जा रहा है.
तभी रास्ते थे भी नहीं ना,
लोग गुस्सा भी तो होंगे ना उस टाइम लाइक ये सब रास्ते बने खाली लोगों को चलने के लिए और ये लोग क्या यार गाड़ी चला रहे हैं हम लोग के रोड पे.
But I sat in the
Rolls Royce at the Atria Mall in Mumbai near Haji Ali.
To lie to them to tell them you want to buy.
No. I was like, "Arey, wow, बहुत अच्छी लग रही है." My dad took me into the showroom. He's like, "हाँ, चल ना, बैठते जाके." And that's when I realized कि just confidence से जाओ, बोलो कि हाँ हाँ. And he's talking to him also कि हाँ, कितना है, कैसे होता है, क्या loans है.
Was it the Phantom or was it the Ghost?
The Phantom. And it was, but the thing was like, इतना luxurious है, but तू क्या करेगा गाड़ी का?
मैं Porsche
Cayenne और the other
GT. Speaking of the
Boxer, what am I saying?
Boxer.
There was this Siddhi and I were at Juhu and we were walking someplace and what happens is that this there's a Rolls Royce Phantom coming and from the other side there's a Renault Duster. Okay, and they fucking the duster slams into the Rolls Royce Phantom.
Okay.
And when it reverses, right? Like you can see the dent on the fucking car. It's like andar dab gaya. Okay. It was so bad that everyone around gasped visibly. Okay. Then the doors open or aisa khulta hai. Aisa.
Amit ji ke paas hai.
Nahi. So it feels like this. The point is that this is a rich car. Right, this is rich. Yeah. This is poor. This
yeah.
is poor. Okay, so the thing opens. Two boys jump out. Okay, they run to the duster and they want to kill this person. They want to fucking murder this person, whoever the fuck has done this, right? So they fling open the door of the duster and they see that there's a girl there. Okay, and I've never seen two guys so disappointed in my whole life. Okay, they were like, "Fuck, yaar, abhi samjhota karna pade." So they give insurance information and they fuck off. Right, the duster goes to the side, parks, the girl comes out, she goes to the bonnet and starts weeping. Because she has realized ki agar insurance doesn't cover this, right? Uska lifetime gaya, abhi repayment.
Yeah.
That car is 11 crores. It's worth more than my dad.
Third party insurance.
Everything that he has ever made.
Dude, I'm telling you, like hitting those cars, it's a night.
No, it's dumb.
My friend has a Jag. He's like, I don't know why I bought this car.
Because
that one mirror goes, no? That mirror to replace the mirror is the Maruti 800. Like it was.
Yeah. Oh, the mirror. Okay, I thought that's the glass. The glass in the mirror of a Mercedes or one of these cars, just the glass is 50,000. Because so some anti-reflective bullshit that they tell you.
The rear view wala jo glass hai na, piche wala hai. So when the floods happened in 26/7, you've seen on the street, work, aisi public chodke chale gaye.
Yeah.
Chal ke aaya ho ghar pe mom ke saath, bro, side pe, raste pe, BMW khadi hai, Q7 padi hui hai udhar, udhar usse side mein ek merc hai. And I've literally seen people, teen log, jo ek Mercedes ka ye pakde khinch rahe hai. कि इनको कैसे कैसे तोड़े तो एक कुछ ट्राई कर रहा है एंड व्हाट यू गोइंग टू डू तो चिल्ला के मत करो तो फक ऑफ ये तोड़ रहे तो एम्बलम तोड़ेगा ना एम्बलम ऊपर का
या
उसका भी पैसा है 5,000
तो अलग अलग होता है बीच में बहुत बड़ा रैकेट हुआ था लाइक इफ यू लीव योर कार इन बॉम्बे सैंटा क्रूज तेरा एम्बलम गया लाइक फ्रॉम अ फियट टू अ रेनॉल्ट एनीथिंग यू लीव तेरा एम्बलम चुरा के लेके ले
जाएगा बीएमडब्ल्यू कैसे ऊपर जो आया हुआ है ना दैट्स अ वेरी वो अलग लेवल पे बिकता है
हां लाइक एंड रोल्स रॉयस का इज कूल दैट वे बिकॉज़ इफ यू टच द रोल्स रॉयस एम्बलम इफ इट फील्स दैट समबडी इज टैम्परिंग विद इट द कार पुल्स इट बैक इनसाइड इट गोस बैक अंडर द बोनेट It goes into the bonnet and shut.
Or ऐसे ऐसे एक उंगली ऐसा बाहर आता है फिर उसके
One second. The Rolls Royce emblem has a foreskin.
Yeah.
Oh fuck.
Yeah, तेरा anesthesia wear off. It took.
Okay.
Guys, sorry. One second. I have one. It just amuses me this thing. So the Rolls Royce, right? It's a combination. The name Rolls Royce is a combination of Sir Henry Royce and Charles Rolls.
Yeah.
And
Charles Rolls, a good joint.
Yeah. Royce okay. founded the company in 1903 and Rolls promoted the car. So, but I just find it very, very unfortunate that there was a man called Rolls.
Yeah.
Okay. And if he hadn't found Royce.
First of all, in India, if you're driving, guys, please high beam pe mat chalo gaadi, low beam pe chalo.
Yeah. Jab chale, I don't know. Karo. Why public please. Does this?
Huh? Aray, because wo dur dikhta hai, uske baad bore ho jata. Okay, I
that was a PSA in the middle.
Yeah.
Sorry. I just realized because I saw one fact about headlamps and I was like, nahi, ye bolna padega. Okay. I want to talk about two things. One is a question, one's a fact. So there was, I don't know if you guys know about this guy. There's a gentleman called Stanley Myers. Was a gentleman. He's no more. Stanley Myers. He is from Ohio, from what I remember. I think he.
तेरा दोस्त है क्या?
No, not at all. I wish. He probably designed something called a water fuel cell. So he designs like the first it was called the perpetual motion machine, right? And what basically the fuel cell did is it split water into its components, hydrogen and oxygen. And hydrogen was burned to generate energy and the process sort of reconstituted the water molecules and stuff like that.
And oxygen and came into the car. So
the end product, instead of carbon dioxide, it used to release oxygen. So the car is actually producing oxygen. And
no, it's not.
Hydrogen.
Don't make up
what?
Stuff. Anyway.
Yeah.
No, he's just made... This is other. Just ignore it. Okay, so Meyer obviously had issued patents and stuff like that. His patents have expired and his inventions are in the public domain and you can, you know, use them without restriction or royalty or whatever it is. But no engine or vehicle manufacturer has incorporated Meyer's work. But here's the conspiracy slash the reality slash whatever happened. In March 20th, 1998, Stanley Meyer was dining at a restaurant. His brother claims that he had a meeting with two Belgian investors and he was meeting them. And suddenly Myers ran outside saying, they poisoned me. And after the investigation, of course, that the report basically ruled that he had high blood pressure and died of a cerebral aneurysm. But a lot of people believe that because he invented a water fuel cell car, he was murdered by the lobby because... I mean, just imagine a water car. You don't have to pay for gas. You don't have to pay for petrol.
No, but if you're saying that this thing is already there, what's stopping people from going out there?
Because
some embargo on accessing.
On what? On accessing?
If he's patented it.
Patent of,
yeah.
The no, his patent has expired. And I know his patent has expired. And I see, I from whatever little you've read about conspiracy theories or about just law, the way it's made in the European and American economies is there's a lot of lobby groups, right? So there's an entire, like, whether it's cigarette lobby or alcohol lobby or like Detroit, the Detroit lobby was the big three at that point. The automobile lobby is pretty huge, right? There's also an entire oil mafia, right? Oil mafia is going to obviously control somebody coming up with a water controlled car. And then that's really where the problem is. Like, if you remember Volkswagen scam, hey,
Baba,
I don't know if you
missed Baba, that. Agar ye water thing ho gaya na, tera Chelsea band ho jayega, kyunki Roman ka paisa.
Nee, lekin BMW also spoke about this.
Yeah, they created a hydrogen car, which was, but they retrofitted it inside one of their V12 7 series. And
Elon Musk has been complaining about the lobby right now,
where
he says that there's a huge opposition to the Tesla car because it's electric, it's an electric car, right? And big lobby wants to big automobile wants you to keep driving the fossil fuel ones. And he says that one of the arguments they say is that, hey, where are the electric charging stations, right? How will you have this car when there are such few charging stations? And he says that this was the same argument that they used when the car was invented, right? People said, hey, we have horses and there is grass everywhere. Where are the petrol pumps? But eventually, when you have enough demand, then everything happens. So it's like we just need to generate enough people to buy the car. So,
if you have opportunity, like I remember the first electric car I drove, Reva, So, my mama still has it. And so my mama is 6'2", his daughter is 6, and mommy is 5'9". So they are 3 really tall people who actually sat inside it.
No, dude. Lifting the car and running with it.
Yeah, dude, I really, but it is an experience because when I took my cousin leke aai, and I told her, I want to drive. She's like, okay, fine, you drive. So I sat down and I said, steering wheel. Then I have to go ahead. So she said, go ahead. So it's automatic, right? So you have to accept there is no like lever to push.
Yeah.
Jaise air conditioning ka button hota na, 1, 2, 3. Aise.
To pump the accelerator.
Drive, neutral, reverse. Literally, jab aisa move kar raha hai wo.
Wow.
Aur fir uske baad daba aur chalegi. So at full charge, 80 kilometers it goes.
Dude, Reva looks like a car you would get at Hamleys.
I love the fact that tu roz aise raat ko phone charge kar raha hai na, bas dekho gaadi bhi rakhna pad raha hai charge karne ke liye.
Aur fir tu subah utha aur bola, oh shit, main switch on karna bhul gaya tha, gaadi charge
nahi. But there are bikes now. There are like really great bikes that have come into play which are electric and are actually like easily handleable.
Like, apne India mein, like, why don't we have solar powered cars? Because
dude, I keep asking this all the fucking time.
So why don't parking for 5 minutes?
No. So there's a documentary that Michael Moore just released very recently, and I think it got taken down by YouTube, and he was complaining for a while. It got taken down. He put the documentary up. He produced it, and it's about all sustainable energy and how it's not technically sustainable because because the parts that are being manufactured for solar panels and stuff like that, they are not being manufactured for longevity. All the windmills are manufactured for about 5 to 10 years or 8 years is their life. And they actually, they need a high level of maintenance. And when they don't work, when there is overcast skies and stuff, then there is a separate place that actually, which is powered by fossil fuel to actually create the electricity backup. So in a way, you're creating more in order to go off, like create a more bio, friendly.
You're spending more.
You're basically doubling the effort, and you're taking silica and you're using silica to actually create the solar panel. So it goes into a deep dive into how sustainable energy is. That's the thing.
Because if you have more people accepting it, if it gets widespread, you will have people who would, like Baba said, come up with alternatives to be able to solve that problem. If a lot of people are adapting to it, like when Elon Musk showed the Tesla wall wala, usse pura US ka map dikha, aur uspe ek itna, probably little less than the size of Utah. He said that's the amount of land we need to power the whole world.
No, but he actually went into Tesla also. The what we're doing is we are mining for silica, and that silica mining is messing up with the other. So you're basically switching from coal to going into heavy duty on silica. So it's about creating a balance.
No, so other, I have a feeling that there is, so I think that there is a second side to the argument.
There definitely is. They're going like, okay, we need to go into a sustainable way of creating power for ourselves. But the thing is, we have not reached it yet. This wind and solar are not the end goals here. We have to probably, there has to be another step here. That is the thing. And the big lobbies are, and the big power lobbies are coming into sustainable power now. They're saying it's sustainable energy. They're going from coal to wood. And they're cutting down trees as opposed to using wood and saying that this is, we are not using coal anymore. So there's a lot of other shit that has come into play that we are not realizing.
Basically, we have to wait until the planet is slightly more fucked and people take it more seriously. Because like the same like people said, ki, hey, you can't stop the world. Corona was sab ruk gaya. So when things get a little more fucked, I think everyone will be like, okay, fine, now we'll do the actual thing.
It's becoming profit driven. The day the only way to keep sustainable energy actually good and green is to keep it, the more these power lobbies now shift over to sustainable energy, like the same. Oil wala mafia is going into sustainable energy, just revamping it and repackaging it.
No, if I think that, happens, I think that's the problem. There needs to be, I think the minute you're able to monetize the energy, which means you create the hardware. See, the bigger problem with sustainable energy is because sustainable energy is based on the myths that it's available to anybody. Right.
Yeah.
The fact that the sun is available or that wind is available, the problem that you have is you can't constantly monetize it. With oil, you have to mine, process, and then the transport.
You have to go to Bharat Petroleum. Then
you have to do all of that. Yeah. So there is an entire chain, right? Here, the cost is maybe exorbitant, but it's a one-time cost. I'll install my entire house with solar panels. Uske baad, I only need to clean it. Servicing ke liye, aadmi nahi aane ga aisa, ID card leke, right? So I think that there needs to be a way to monetize it for these big companies, because otherwise you're looking at an entire chain reaction breaking down. Bawa, so I think there's
Bawa, you're totally right, because you pay for the petrol, but you never pay for the air. The air is always like, jo dena hai do. Because it's freely available, and if you wanted, you could have sat at home and blown it into your tire.
But you know, like talking about like alternate this for cars as well, right? 92% of all like new cars in Brazil, they all use ethanol as fuel, which is basically made from sugarcane.
Yeah.
So log wo kar rahe hain. On the other hand, you have places like Turkmenistan. Okay, Turkmenistan gives a certain amount of petrol free, like 120 liters, that's 31 gallons of free petrol to people a month.
Wow.
Yeah, but in India, technically, across the world, diesel is more expensive than petrol. But in India, it's subsidized, right? It's subsidized by the government because our transport system runs on diesel. So it's subsidized by the government because it's actually not a cleaner petrol compared to petrol. So
Anyway, I have some more facts.
I want to ask one question. What's your favorite movie car of all time?
Movie car?
From movies.
Aston Martin, the James Bond Aston Martin.
The DB5. The DB5.
The DB8. One that Pierce Brosnan had in.
Vanquish.
Pierce Brosnan in which one? GoldenEye?
No, in
Tomorrow Never Dies.
Tomorrow Never Dies.
Oh, the Green Viper.
Yeah. The one was in.
Not the Batmobile,
all of that was on the table, what?
Of course, it's there.
What about like Knight Rider? And like,
dude, I was going
to
say
the car from the Back to the Future.
DeLorean, Speed Racer. Oh yeah,
that car, the M.
That is the car.
Mark 5.
The Mark 5.
There's DB5 from James Bond.
DB8 also. Aston Martin DB8 जो डैनियल क्रेग चलाया था वो था डेलोरियन का, यू नो द होल स्टोरी, उसके ऊपर पिक्चर भी बना था अभी.
क्या था डेलोरियन?
डेलोरियन के गाड़ी के ऊपर.
रिक्रिएशन ऑफ द टम्बलर, इट्स कॉल्ड द कार टू फाइट द ज़ॉम्बी अपोकैलिप्स. सो समबडी हैज बेसिकली टेकन द मर्सिडीज मायबाख एंड टर्न्ड इट इनटू समथिंग दैट क्लियरली
दिलीप चांडी. व्हाट? मर्सिडीज मायबाख.
टैंक एंड दिस
इज डीसी दिलीप छापड़ा.
नहीं डीसी नहीं लग रहा मेरे को. ही टर्न्ड इट इनटू अ टैंक एंड लाइक एन ऑल्टरनेट व्हीकल.
आर यू गोना पुट इट इन योर बैकग्राउंड?
I'm trying to. पहली बार हो रहा नहीं है. हाँ हो रहा है. चल. This is the car and this is a Mercedes Maybach.
Wow.
Oh, dude, someone needs to give this to UP police because उनके गाड़ी flip flop.
Dude, please don't give this idea to Rohit Shetty, bro.
Flip flop करेंगे, bro.
Please don't give this idea to Rohit Shetty.
So, this fact is about how the Tata Sumo got its name. Okay. The Tata
Some
Sumo,
racist thing. I hope no, it's no, something
no.
racist.
So, obviously, one, it was named because of its size and dimensions. It was a large car for its time.
Uh-huh.
And secondly, and this is more of the what it was, it's a tribute to Sumant Mulgaonkar, a former MD of Tata Motors. The name Sumo is a play on the first syllable of his name and last name. So, Sumant Mulgaonkar. So Sumo.
Oh.
I'm also assuming that that's what he was called.
I used to have a Tata Sumo. Wow. Eons ago.
Dude, the ad for Tata Sumo was unreal.
Also, incidentally, the S-Team was named because it was bought by people with low self-esteem.
So the guy who invented the cruise control was blind.
That I just found out. What is his name?
I don't know.
Mahesh.
नाम नहीं दिया, सिर्फ बोला कि वो अंधा था.
That's pretty impressive, man.
Yeah, dude.
But you know, your जब भी तेरा crash हो रहा है, if you have airbags, you know how long it takes for the airbags to inflate?
Like point less than 0.00
milliseconds. Point 40 milliseconds, 40 milliseconds, something like that. Not 0.40 milliseconds, 40 milliseconds. It takes for the car.
Yeah. The amount of testing,
the airbags to come out.
Like sometimes you just look, like I've seen testing videos and they're like, oh, बहुत मजा आता है देखने के लिए. Just people crashing cars.
देखने में मजा आता है, bro.
हाँ.
By the way, why hasn't India produced another F1 driver after Naren Karthikeyan?
Because सबकी मम्मी बोल रही है इतना तेज मत चलाओ.
No.
क्योंकि सब उबर ओला ले रहे हैं. इकोनॉमी की लगी है, कोई गाड़ी खरीद रहा नहीं है. गाड़ी खरीदा नहीं तो सीख गया कैसा.
Abhinav Bindra had said this. I think I saw an interview of Abhinav Bindra. He's like, why can't India have more gold medalist shooters or like Olympians? He's like, it takes a lot of money. I come from a... And he was so cool about acknowledging the fact that my father is very, very rich. He gave me a shooting range with perfect pristine conditions for me to practice in. That is what it takes. And that's what it takes to become an Olympian. It takes a lot of money. So when you say that there's lack of talent, there's a lot of talent, but there's no money to actually harness that talent. So it comes down to the same thing. Agar paisa nahi hai, then how do you get into these high level sports? Like it takes a lot of money.
This is so cool. Like while on the subject of car safety and driving safety, Sweden's Volvo made the 3-point seatbelt design patent open and available to other manufacturers for free in the interest of safety.
This is Volvo, no?
Volvo. It saves one life every 6 minutes.
Whoa. Yeah, yeah.
And no, even Elon Musk did. Even all the patents with Tesla, they're all open source.
Open source.
Yeah.
तू किस तेरको बनाना है बैठ के तू बना.
Sweden का एक और था. Sweden has issued the most expensive ticket ever. Like
no, that ticket. Was what we discussed in the podcast with the ticket which Kautuk found with what? That Tempo driver.
71,000.
No,
this was 1 million euro. I think it was 1 million euro apparently. No, because in Sweden it's according to your salary or your annual income. So your speeding ticket is based on how much. So ye aadmi ka kitna paisa ke iska ticket was made for 1 million.
I just want to show you this.
Funny.
This car is called the Zunda Pianus. It's one of the worst designed cars of all time.
So tu gaadi drive karke phir raza aise.
Yes. Someone thought, you know what? I want to get into my car from the bonnet and the dicky.
Engine ka hai gaadi ka? Actually, engine ka rakha hai gaadi ka?
The car was so poorly designed.
Wo engine pe baithta hai. Seat nahi hai gaadi mein. Engine hai, uske upar tu baithta hai. To tu bhi garam hua to.
Oh, it's so bad, this fucking car.
But it's insane though, right? In 1900, 40% of American cars were powered by steam, 38% by electricity, and only 22% by gasoline.
Oh, so we lost.
So the market was completely ulta.
Yeah.
Ulta.
Very sad.
What's the best Bollywood movie car that you had?
Tarzan the Wonder.
Yeah, Tarzan the Wonder car.
Yeah. सोचना भी नहीं पड़ता है सोचना भी नहीं पड़ता है तू क्या obvious questions
come on guys there have been other cars
it has the spirit of the boy's father
बाबा is going to mention some 80s movie
yeah तेरे को night rider अच्छा लगता है
villain had one specific car
no
वो था Contessa was the villain car
dude Malabar Cadillac is a Contessa I just want to say
Malabar Cadillac. Oh, this is why I knew Baba had a reason. Oh, fuck. I knew it.
उसमें भी घुसा दिया बाबा ने मलाबार कैडिलैक
एक्सप्रेशन.
बाबा प्रमोशन ठीक है तू कर ही रहा है तो मैं भी कर रहा हूँ ये ले.
No, no, no. My
book, it has no cars.
अरे but one sec, my promotion is not there. Varun mentioned Contessa, so I said Contessa.
घंटा, you are going to be like my favorite Bollywood car is Malabar Cadillac.
Yeah. No. It's not Bollywood. It's an English movie. It's an indie film. Guys.
Oh, yeah.
Abhe, lekin tu Indian hai, Ranveer Shori Indian hai. So, picture Bolli hai. Samjha? Anti-national. But on the topic of patents, okay, so the inventor of intermittent windshield wipers jo hota hai na, tried to sell his ideas to like different auto companies, auto industry rather. And he was turned away. Suddenly, all new cars started showing up with that. So he sued and he won each time.
Oh, there's a movie about this. Who was Batman? Michael Keaton is the actor in this movie. They've actually made a movie on this life, a biopic. It was actually a pretty good movie. Yeah.
Michael Keaton, kitne biopic kar raha hai, bro? Usse wo McDonald's ke upar bhi wohi
tha. Batman bhi kiya usne.
Batman bhi kiya. Wo best biopic of his was Batman.
No,
and
no,
Birdman. And Birdman.
And Life because, from Baghdad, bro. Where he plays that reporter, producer from the CNN.
By the way, another fun, rather sad fact is that each year, more people are killed in car accidents than they are killed by malaria.
Because machar aata hai na gaadi ke andar bhi.
Machar to aise chalata hai. But you can't get malaria after you dead. So.
Dude, my...
Oh, sorry, my bad. It wasn't Michael Keaton. It was Greg Kinnear. The actor is Greg Kinnear. And the movie's name is Flash of Genius. And lead actor is Greg Kinnear from Little Miss Sunshine.
Huh. Or Forrest Gump.
Now that Adar has given that fact, it is time to end the podcast.
Yes.
I'm going to run through a few more.
I have a Hitler fact.
Louis Chevrolet, the founder of Chevrolet, he died bankrupt and poor working as a mechanic for the company he started.
Hey, what is this? The plot of Bazigar?
No, Baba, this is the plot of SNG comedy.
Yeah.
Oh, it's funny because it's true.
it's too true. Too true.
No, so I mean, think about it. The Volkswagen, Volkswagen, what Adar was saying as a Hitler
fan. I was going to say personal story, but say fact first.
Volkswagen was a German company by the Nazis because of the people's car, right?
The Volkswagen.
And by the way, Volkswagen, I don't know if you've seen that thing on Netflix, that documentary where Volkswagen basically cheated the entire, like, pretty much the northern continent, northern hemisphere, by lying about its emission standards and hiding it in reports and stuff like that. But the Volkswagen group owns like Audi and like it pretty much owns all of that. So
Audi, BMW.
I'll tell you exactly because I had found it. It's one company owning a fuck ton of others. Was it Volkswagen only? Yeah, Volkswagen owns Bugatti. It owns Porsche. It owns what else?
BMW. Audi. Audi also.
I think so. Audi GmbH.
Audi can't be BMW.
One sec. Let me check. I think Audi GmbH is owned by this thing. We'll see. One sec. Hold on.
If it owns BMW,
Volkswagen.
Also...
There you go. Volkswagen. Whoa. Volkswagen owns. I'll tell you what all Volkswagen owns. Okay. Volkswagen owns the Seat, Skoda, Porsche. It's also got... No. I'm sorry. Hold on. Please hold on one second. Volkswagen owns Audi, that's for sure.
But BMW also for sure.
Of course.
Yeah, Volkswagen owns Bentley, Bugatti, Lamborghini, Audi, Ducati and Porsche.
Yeah. And
Mini
Scania,
Cooper. And Mini and Cooper Seat, also then.
And Seat and... what's it called? Man, like from that, like Man, the Jeep, the truck company, and all of that. So it owns that also. So yeah, just FYI.
Oh, shit. This is a really weird fact. 75% of all cars produced by Rolls Royce are still on the road.
Oh, not even separate.
Do you guys know the story about the Rolls Royce where there was a Maharaja? This was a pre-independence. A Maharaja went and tried to buy a Rolls Royce and
they didn't give it to him.
Yeah, they told him that you can't buy this car, right? So what he did is he went to a different place, he bought this car, and in vengeance he used the Rolls Royce as a garbage collection
truck. Yeah, so
basically every morning the Rolls Royce would come and you'd put your kachra into the back of the thing, right? So, Rolls-Royce find out about this and they contact the guy and they're like, listen, our image is taking a beating. You can't use it as a garbage truck. Okay, so he's like, I told you, you should have let me buy it. Why did you do discrimination? Now, fuck.
Wow, that's insane.
Wow, boss. Yeah, Maharaja OP.
Maharaja OP in the chat. Wow, bro.
Hitler apparently begged Mercedes to give him a specific... They literally he did that. He begged Mercedes to give him their latest car, the limousine, the Mercedes limousine at the time, because uska Mein Kampf ka royalty check nahi aaya tha. So he couldn't pay for it. So he begged them to give it to him.
So can you imagine Hitler going for this loan? Sir, aap collateral mein kya de rahe ho? Poland.
कोलैटरल में तेरी जान बख्श रहा हूँ, ठीक है? जब भी लोन जल्दी साइन साइन
कोलैटरल आपको अंदर आएगा, कोलैटरल मांग रहा है कि कोलैटरल डैमेज चाहिए थे।
हिटलर गॉट कंफ्यूज, अरे उसने बोला कोलैटरल डैमेज चाहिए था, ये लो आधा कॉन्टिनेंट यूरोप का।
Bro, personal story, speaking of miscarrying and
doing the wrong. I love how you start a personal story by personal story.
Yeah, because that's what it is at this point, right? So basically, my dad, we had bought a Honda City, okay? So that was the car, and excitedly he told his mom, right, my grandmom. He's like, we got a new car, it's a Honda City, right? And grandmoms being grandmoms, she had to tell the whole family about it, right? So she calls up relatives and she's like, "Pata hai kya? Mere bete ne naya gaadi kharida hai, Hero Honda." Okay. And all her relatives are like, "Aap itni khush kyu hai? Wo car se bike pe aa gaya, aap itni khush?"
Hilarious. That's hilarious. और हम लोग इसी वुड हैव गॉन फॉरवर्ड से कहा भी हम लोग सब फैमिली ट्रिप पे जाने वाले हैं, हम लोग सब चार लोग मिलके चार लोग जाएंगे अब हाँ हाँ हीरो होंडा
मेरे माय ग्रैंडफादर यूज्ड टू डू दिस सो दे हैड अ स्कूटर नानू हैड वन ऑफ दोस ओल्ड स्कूटर्स जिसका ऐसे दबा के ऐसे घुमाना होता है और गियर चेंज के लिए तो पूरा को पूरा हैंडल ऊपर नीचे जाता है रिक्शा स्टाइल तो दैट्स द ओल्ड स्कूटर जहां पे ब्रेक नीचे पैर पे होता था
यस आदर दैट्स एवरी स्कूटर फ्रॉम वेस्पा टू एवरीथिंग बजाज
The old ones, huh? So, Nanu, what they did was, my mom's brother used to sit in the middle. Like, Nanu and Nani, normal seat pe baithe. And beech mein, like, my mother's brother is sitting. And wo jo tire hota hai piche ka, jo seedha hai, usko flat kiya tha. Aur tire pe meri mummy baithti thi. So, then it was a scooter limousine.
Wow. That
they had created. Nice.
That's crazy.
Nice.
No, by the way, you know, most presidents, right, or prime ministers, they have to have an armored car. So the first armored presidential car in the U.S. was a Cadillac that was previously owned by Al Capone.
By Neville.
By Neville, yeah. By Al Capone. Al Capone used to use it. वैसे टॉकिंग अबाउट कार्स ब्रो द यूएस प्रेसिडेंट का तू द बीस्ट देखेगा उसके ऊपर मैंने इतने सारे वीडियोस देखे.
So many videos, yeah, yeah.
And it's so cool to watch. Modi ji के पास भी है.
Haan, the BMW something.
But yeah. He borrows it from Ambani. Apparently.
Ambani.
Yeah.
This is true. Shit.
This is the true fact. Shit.
No.
This is not a true fact. Ambani.
I'm pretty sure
this is it. A being human edit.
Kautuk, you were talking about grandmom, Hero Honda and stuff like that. Just like it's so fascinating because like I work in advertising and across careers I've done various cars and I've done various bikes and stuff like that. First of all, shooting cars and bikes is just it's chaos, it's fun, it's exhilarating, it's everything. Okay, but
it's not bad. Like, it's both.
It's annoying. It's annoying as fuck because some cars are just so ugly. You can't even the three-quarter frontal looks ugly, so you can't find a good angle to shoot the car. So, but it's challenging. It's great fun, and also like the grips that you work with are crazy when you're shooting cars.
What? How would you shoot this car?
Yeah.
What do you do?
With a gun.
What would you do to sell this car? Like actually putting like what would you do to market this car? Somebody's like, ye le 10 crore rupiah, baba. 10 crore rupiah, main tereko de raha hu. Ye gaadi ka market.
Opens from the front. It opens the front and the back. But Kautuk Bandkar, 1 minute. So the thing is, like all these words, know that people have like been given, like you know, the vocabulary has been filled by just like marketing gimmicks, right? Like multi-point fuel injection, like MPFI, or like when you go to a, it's just vocabulary that's given to you so you can have a conversation with the salesman. Sure. Iska CC kitna hai? Acha, isme kitna gear hai? Tere ko kuch samajh mein nahi aata.
Isme kitna gear hai?
Like, yeah, you're just
legit
having
question.
These conversations.
Legit
apart
question.
From kitna deti hai,
16.
16.
Apart from... kitna tire hai, isme kitna tire hai.
Yeah, but then there'll be... You, remember, what is power break? What is power break? How many people know what actually that is, right? Like, nobody knows this kind of stuff. But it's like just
the only time I use this lingo is also when I'm at a dealership about to get a car.
Yeah,
that's not every day.
अब वो लोग बोलते भी ऐसे यार हम लोग नहीं वो लोग बोलते भी वो बोलते भी ऐसे सर इट हैज पावर ब्रेक्स इट हैज अ मल्टीफंक्शनल रेड लाइनिंग सिस्टम व्हिच विद मल्टीपल एलई एलईएसएस एज एबी एबीएस एंड हम लोग भी ऐसे हां 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 बोल रहे हैं जैसे हम लोग बहुत समझ रहे हैं वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस तो मम्मी पूछती है क्या है मैं बाद में बताता हूं
आल्सो आई वांट टू फकिंग बाबा दिस यू नो वन थिंग दैट अननॉयज मी अबाउट कार एड्स इज दैट दे ऑलवेज डू दिस मार्केटिंग फॉर एसयूवी एड्स इन बॉम्बे Right, which is like, and the marketing for SUV ads is look the great outdoors, right? And you're looking at this fucking ad stuck in traffic.
On the mime.
Yeah, exactly, right?
And I just want you know how you know what the biggest insight for an SUV or an MUV is, right? What? The biggest insight to sell that car is to sell it to a person who is so busy that their only dream is I'm going to take it out for a weekend.
That makes sense.
That's the insight for an MUV or an SUV car that you are actually selling.
So basically, not, people who buy it are chutias, right? Is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Like Adar had a Renault Duster.
Yeah.
Oh,
I used the hell out of it. That car used to transport all my instruments and stuff. That car was the best car that I had actually to transport everything that I needed for my shows.
I just think that like if you look at all of these MUVs, like if you're buying like people who buy Range Rovers in Bombay, I mean, wow, what a car. Like, I want the Range Rover. But, like, a Range Rover in Bombay is just like a Hummer in the middle of, like, you know, in the middle of nowhere. Like what a car the Hummer was.
Hummer in the middle of nowhere would actually be a logical option.
But yeah, you know
that's,
what
that's literally what the Hummer is made
the
for.
Middle of nowhere is either a logical option or a scene from an Akshay Kumar movie.
Also, you know, we should also like, how the fuck did the Wagoner become an Uber?
That's it. Like some cars just become the, like they represent, they become taxis.
And you know, it's actually a fear for a lot of companies.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's because a lot of companies end up becoming just that, right? Like now, like a lot of companies worry about them becoming fleet vehicles, right? Mm. So they do their best to avoid selling it to fleet vehicles or companies that do fleets, right? Like for example, what is that? Like the Mahindra Logan with the
Hameru. It became the Meru.
You know what I'm saying? So yeah. Like a lot of them worry about. Okay, this is what, because also once it's bought by a fleet company, that car is going to be in circulation for 10 to 12 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Nobody else new is buying it, right? So there's a lot of like nuance when you're marketing a car and you want to be certain that you know the right kind of people make sure that you buy it, and how do you make sure that it doesn't become a fleet vehicle.
Tantro ko nahi hua aisa, even though the Kali Pili
like,
adopted.
That's like the Corolla becoming the five-star hotel pickup and drop car.
Yeah.
So, sab se Corolla waisi ban gaye.
Oh, Honda Accord.
Oh, yeah. Huh?
Yeah, Honda Accord. Abhi kaun sa gaadi chala raha hai, Baba?
Main toh abhi bhi city, lekin mere ko abhi, as of this moment, upgrade karne hai. So, I'm starting to consider. So I'm looking at options.
What options are you looking at?
Please send me
Hero Honda
options. Hero Honda. No, dude.
Are you BMW chala rahe hai abhi ki tune bhej diya?
Nahi, bhej diya usne bro.
Almost, yeah. So the thing is, I don't have a car anymore, and I'm so happy. It's just. I realized that I had a car
until the pandemic. I was very happy.
No, I'm telling you, that would, I would agree with you, but after what's happened during the lockdown and everything. I'm so fucking glad ki gaadi kharida, because I was also kyun kharidu, fuck it, I'll just take whatever Ola Uber type situation, but khud ka gaadi ek,
I am very happy with the car, because also with work and all, it's just the best. Like if I'm shooting in Film City, I can leave at 3 in the morning and I don't have to worry about like an Uber coming to Film City.
Yeah.
It's to me the independence that a car gives me. Like Shilim, dude. I came to Shillim. I didn't have to take the bus. I came to Shillim and then I just drove back, right?
Always.
To me, a car is
no, great. I'm
thinking, by cars. The way, 1 minute, guys. I'm really curious about this. Please give me advice. I'm thinking, so in my head, I'm going from an Audi, which I don't want to buy. I'm telling you now only. I don't want to buy.
Hey, why would you say that?
He's asking, basically, this is just how to level select a car.
Yeah, I'm asking Paltan. And also the new Honda Accord, apparently the new Honda Accord is really great.
The Civic is sick.
Yeah. The Civic is what I was genuinely, I think udhar hi jayega mera Accord. But after that I will check it
out. Baba, Wagoner lena.
Wagoner le, please. Baba, Wagoner.
I can't do Wagoner because I just like
fully loaded Wagoner. Like
there's no automatic Wagoner.
Rear cam.
Bro, if a Wagoner is fully loaded, you won't be able to go ahead.
No, Wagoner is fully loaded when it is the Uber pool and everyone is sat in it.
I've actually been in a Wagoner Uber pool where there was a dude and like main aaya and mere baju mein ek koi other student baitha tha aur एक आदमी आया जिसने दो सीट बुक किया था एंड ही वाज मेकिंग अ डिलीवरी कोई केक की आर्टिसन केक की दुकान थी जिसमें उसने फ्रंट सीट पे चार केक रखे और फिर अपने गोदी में भी चार केक लेके बैठा है एंड ही इज मेकिंग अ केक डिलीवरी और हमारे बगल में बैठा है
Bro, that's so many people.
इसके बॉस ने प्रॉपर उबर एक्स के पैसे दिए लेकिन इसने उबर पूल करके जो भी पैसे बचे वो अपने पास रखे होंगे आठ केक लेके तू क्यों जाएगा उबर पूल में
So by the way, there are lots of guys who think Uber Pool is a dating app.
Yeah. Like, aaj ek ladki milegi. The girl of my dreams is going to open this door
and walk in. And nobody told them, in log roz gaadi mein jaake baithenge. Hi, I'm Arun. What's your name?
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to talk to you. What are your hobbies? You know?
And then Seema aunty comes and sits in the front seat.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think we've got enough of this episode. This will keep going on because it's cars. So we will do a part two of
cars.
Part two is of cars.
Yeah. If you want to see a part two of cars, please mention everything we have said on this podcast.
Because we forget what we've said in part one.
Yeah. No, but that's the main thing that's popping. What do you like about cars? Which is your favorite car? And which is your favorite car from movies? Which car do you currently drive? And how many cc or horsepower?
And what car should Baba buy?
And how much will you pay in Super Chat to help him achieve that goal?
I'm calling it right now that all comments are going to be like Malabar Cadillac, Malabar Cadillac.
Yeah,
Malabar
Baba Cadillac. Is next going to buy a Contessa.
Guys, genuinely help me buy one, man. I don't know.
And if you all comment the maximum number of cars, car name that is commented, Baba will buy that car only.
He will buy the car.
That's the promise.
He will buy the car.
Yes, yes.
I'm telling you now, only. And whatever car you all comment about the most, Baba will buy that car.
Even if it's a Zen.
He'll go back in time. But he will
notice that.
Dude, the new Zen is coming out. Right? There's a new Zen coming out, by the way. They're revamping and releasing the new Zen.
You know, I have editing control, no? By the way, the new ambassador is fantastic. Huh?
Baba, you have editing control, but I will comment and pin on the comment section. That you will buy the car that they comment about the most.
I am not buying the car that they comment on, but the new ambassador is sick.
Or
this. Or what Baba needs.
The Zundab
shit.
No, the Zundab Janu.
That's it from this episode of the Internet Web Show. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys again next week. Until then, do whatever you want. Drive whatever car.
Hi, Salman.
Don't drive. Unless you have to absolutely go out.
Do whatever the feeling you want.
Okay. Bye, guys. See you. Bye.
Bye, guys. Hold up. I've actually sat in a random dude's car. I went with a friend and uske paas Santro thi. And it's a white color Santro. And main bahar gaya ki main ko thoda, like we were going to town. So maine bola mujhe bathroom ja raha hai. So we stopped at a restaurant. I went to pee. And I don't want him to get late. So main karke bhag ke aaya. I saw the car. I opened the door, sat. And there is a shocked man on the phone. I sat in the wrong car. There was another Santro of the same color. वो ऐसे देख रहा और मैं अंदर घुस के ऐसे उसके डैशबोर्ड पे चल अभी चलते हम लोग वर्ली एंड आई लुक एट हिम ही इज जस्ट वर्ली क्यों जाने गए
तो मैं और बात नहीं कर सकता अभी तो दर्द हो रहा है मेरे को दर्ड हो रहा है
द डस्टर इज सच अ शिट नेम फॉर अ कार